Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Darkestvile Castle with me, Demonox, as the demon said. Let's talk to Porky. Hello, Piggy. What?
It's a hideous pig.
Astute, as always.
Hello. Hey, look. If you come here on behalf of Vigo to see if I've already dispatched this chest as he ordered me, tell him, Corey, I'm part of the Demonic Trade Union. I know my rights, and according to the Demonic Trade Act, Article 23, I can take all the time I want to perform a task. And even if in the Part B he is allowed to send a third party to tell me please hurry up, in Part C, it's stated clearly that I'm allowed to reply, hey, this thing is taking more time than I expected. So hey, this thing is taking more time than I expected.
Who are you?
Who are you? Me? I'm Mark Piglinton, but everybody calls me Mr. Piglinton, proud member of the Demonic Trade Union. I am a licensed crew member specialized in high mass logistics operations.
What?
I move heavy things.
Oh,
you're a new recruit, right? I don't remember seeing your face.
Yes, I'm the new guy. I'm an operator specialized in the delivery of messages, news, notification announcements, and other pieces of valuable information relevant to our organization.
What?
I'm the errand boy.
Oh.
I like that.
Did Vigo tell you to dispatch that chest?
According to the directives I received, it should be dropped by the river to sink.
He told me not to drop it there yet, but he may come up with a better idea soon.
That would infer a delay on a planned activity. According to the Demonic Trade Act, Article 83, I could demand the delay to cease and start working on said planned activity immediately. A thing that I will not do. If the management needs to momentarily stop this operation, I understand it, and I...
Gladly, I don't have to do anything.
So generous.
It also means I don't have to do anything.
Wanna lift that golden goblet over there? It won't turn you in...
What?
Nothing, just forget it.
Yeah, he's already a pig, I can't really do anything.
Can I join the Demonic Trade Union?
Of course you can.
Wait, just fill out this one.
Minor requirements, though. You have to go to the main office to do the usual paperwork, they check your background, and of course you have to be a legal citizen of the Fifth Health. Your blood type should be A++. You have to donate 75% of your salary to the Demonic Trade Union for a minimum of 3 eternities. You have to sacrifice your firstborn to Lord Zordak, the Destroyer of Galaxies. And lastly, you should not be in any way, shape, or form associated with those goddamn Christmas elves. Those miserable Santa zealots were stealing our jobs lately, so we are currently at war with them.
Ah, jeez, I'm not sure what my blood type is.
I know that Lord Zordak thing might sound a bit harsh at first, but thanks to him, we got an awesome dental plan. Believe me, I regret nothing. You should think about it.
Okay.
Vigo sent me some new orders for you. You should dismantle the gates of Darkestvile Castle.
Sorry, according to the Demonic Trade Act, Article 4, I'm only assigned to one specific activity, and that activity is moving stuff around. You should contact the Dismantling Department to do that. Sadly, the guys from the Dismantling Department were dismantled. They exploded after they tried to dismantle a bomb.
Aww, poor dudes. What do you do? I don't know if it's just
what does the trade union do?
The Demon Trade Union is an inclusive coalition of minions, imps, and lesser evils that are employed by a main villain or villainous corporation. We seek to improve the conditions of every hard-working member of the society.
That sounds pretty great.
Yep. Yes. In fact, thanks to the Demonic Trade Union that lobbied along the right-wing fairy coalition, we receive a subsidy on the price we pay for magic dust. Of course, now the gnomes have to pay twice the price they used to pay. But screw them. They should have supported us when we tried to pass the Ban All Holly Damage Weapons Act.
Oh, well, that.
Oh, The boss just told me that he wants you to drop it in the open crypt in the graveyard. But don't enter the crypt. Just drop it by the entrance ladder. Some of the steps on the ladder are broken and we don't want you to get injured. May the gods protect us from what the demonic trade act demands we do if you get injured.
What? That's not only a change of plans, but a further distance to carry that thing. Or, according to the demonic trade act, Article 84, in the case of an unexpected change of plans of a previous planned activity, the union member can strike until their demands are met. So, I'm on strike.
And what's your demands?
Are met.
What?
Sorry, you heard me. I'm on strike. I don't move that chest until my demands are met.
What are your demands exactly?
Demand a camel lid sandwich, a decaffeinated digestive, and a good sweet dessert.
What kind of demands are those?
I have no idea. I remember them from a union brochure they sent us monthly in case we need to strike and we run out of ideas for demands. It's very useful.
Oh, thank you. So I need a what's it?
What are your demands? I demand a camel lid sandwich.
Camel lid sandwich.
Caffeinated digestive and a good sweet dessert.
Okay.
I have a see ya.
So I need to get him a sandwich, a digestive, and a dessert. I'm gonna try this out because for. See if it works. Wait, how about?
Look what I got here.
Do you think that because... Oh my god, he has a bone. He has a bone, he has a bone. Please throw it. Please throw it. Throw it. Throw it for God's sake. Just
throw it.
Go get it.
Whee!
Here it is. Here it is. Here it is. If you tell someone you saw this, I will sue you.
Okay, if somebody asks me, this never happened.
Yes, this never happened.
To the inventory you go.
I threw a boat.
It's a green lizard tail.
Right. I think I could change that to purple. Hold on. I kind of did that a little swim because I wanted to see if it would work, but it's like... You think just because you... Oh my god, I got a boat. Please, throw. I got it! I'm gonna turn this purple, because we wanted a purple lizard tail.
Now I've got a purple lizard tail.
It was formerly green. She did say a purple one, right? Must have, like, died or something.
There's nothing useful left.
Ah, I've already looted it. Oh well. I was hoping there was something less in there so I could nick it. He's got a lot of food. A lot of gold. I don't want the gold.
Hello, gentlemen.
Hello.
Hello, my friend. Lovely night to play dice, isn't it?
Yes.
I bet I could defeat you at dice.
Oh, you look really confident, my friend.
What's
this? Let's see if that confidence is.
That's a bad idea. He never loses.
Ha! That's because he's never played against me.
I like your attitude. What are you going to bet?
What can be gambled at dice games?
Right now, I'm gambling a lot of money. Do you have any cash to match my bet?
Do you accept evil card?
So you don't have any cash, do you?
Not at this moment.
Maybe you want to bet your soul?
Sorry, I don't have one.
I see.
First of all,
huh? Firstborn son, then.
I apologize, but I never wanted to have kids.
What about the flesh of an innocent person?
There are not many innocent people around town.
The flesh of an innocent animal, at least?
I'm not sure about that. How do I know if it was innocent?
Oh, the meat is really tender when the animal was innocent.
Okay,
What can be
right now?
Oh, same conversation.
What about the flip?
Oh,
what kind of?
Oh, we're playing
the Southern Hell version.
The game is really simple to learn. Each player places a bet, and then they throw the dice. The lowest number wins the game.
Okay. Zero is lower.
I have to leave.
Spice sausage is tender enough?
It looks weird, but it is really tender. I wonder what kind of meat if it's meat at all.
I'm gonna bet a sausage.
So, you're going to bet the flesh of an innocent animal then?
Oh! I sensed the flesh of a thousand different animals on that item you have. Yes, yes, of course.
It's a very, it's a hot dog.
An expensive item, crafted especially for demonic rituals, and it can even be used for weekend barbecues.
All right then, I bet all my money.
Let's play.
Let's play. Take this dice.
Remember, the lowest number wins.
Ha! Double one. Your turn.
These are a pair of really suspicious dice.
No, we're not.
Shush.
What? Who said that?
They look so like dice.
Hey, that's very
impressive. Double zero.
Victory couldn't be
sweeter.
No, this could not be. I'm sorry, Lord of Darkness. I was defeated. Forgive me.
No.
What was that?
Oh, just forget it. He's overreacting. He does this every time he loses something. Tomorrow he'll be back to gambling again.
I see.
He is a really bad loser. I apologize on his behalf. And please, don't forget to take
it.
It's yours.
Awesome.
My main. He's a bad loser. He does it all the time, probably. It wasn't him going poof or exploding, he's just going, no!
It's a lot of shiny, lovely, happy gold. I don't know how much money is here. I never was good with numbers. Usually Mr. Buttons helps me with that kind of stuff.
Uh-huh. A lot of money. Let's go to him.
Oh, you haven't gone and I already miss you. We shared so little time together, but I really got attached to you, my shiny little friend. Goodbye. Giovanni, take this. This is the money I owed you.
Yup, definitely. This is a really unusual night. Okay, Sid, your account is
back to zero.
If you want to place an order, please let me know.
May I order my money back?
I want to order my money back. That's fine. Oh, well, we can now talk to him and make an order.
Something to wake up a friend that accidentally took sleeping pills?
I can give you some coffee.
I don't think simple coffee is going to work.
Potent coffee.
He's very big, and he took really strong sleeping pills.
Yeah, I give up.
Then I know something that could work. I heard the legend of a coffee so strong that it could actually kill a sleeping elephant.
But I don't want to kill him.
I just want to wake him up.
The legend says that it was used on the Hebrew slaves of the ancient Aztec Empire to completely build the whole International Space Station in just 1 week.
Notice that this legend you're speaking of has inconsistencies
on so many levels.
Give me a break, kid. Don't look at the small details. The main point here is, this coffee could wake up your friend. We're not talking about any ordinary coffee, understand? We're talking about El Café de la Muerte.
Where'd I get taco from?
Hey, that sounds pretty great. Please, I would like to order that.
Unfortunately, it's really complicated to make, and I don't have all the ingredients.
There you go, another fetch quest.
What ingredients are missing? I'll find them for you.
Oh, I have almost all the items to make it, from the death parrot to the musical mice. Only 4 ingredients are missing.
Yep, there you go.
A piece of fresh fruit, some fish scales, expired medicine, and a hat that's never been worn before.
That sounds really arbitrary and random, but don't worry. I will find those items for you. I would like to make an order.
What can I do you for?
Something to drink. Eat.
I'd like to order something to eat.
Sure. Like what?
Order duck with nothing though. Given the fact it's a pig, I don't think anything with bacon would work.
Do you have a robot Tyrannosaurus Rex that can fly and shoot laser beams?
What?
You don't have that?
What no. makes you think I could have such a thing in a tavern?
I don't know. I just saw the question on the dialogue menu, and I was wondering that maybe the option to ask you about that was there for a reason.
What are you talking about?
Nothing.
You know, different options that appear when I'm about to talk to you.
No, I have no idea what you're
talking about. Game poke.
Of course I know what you're talking about, but we're not supposed to talk about the game interface. You're ruining the player's immersion.
No!
Ooh, I see. Hmm. Sorry. I'll try to keep those kinds of conversations at the minimum in the future.
I would like to make...
What can I...
Something to eat?
I'd like to order...
Sure.
Like to order the vegetarian option? Because I can't eat... If people eat that.
I would like to order the vegetarian option.
Sure. Here you go. The vegetarian option.
Are you sure this is okay? This is just a bowl of salt.
Do you see any meat in there?
No.
Then that is the vegetarian
option. Like my order?
I would like.
What can I?
Going to drink.
I would like to order.
Sure thing, bud. But I'm running out of drinks here. The only thing I have left is beer, diet soda, and Fernet.
What's.
I would like to order some Fernet.
Here it goes.
Okay.
I better.
See you soon.
So apparently in the gate they don't like us talking about the fact that it's a game interface. Boom, 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 boom. Now we saw something holding the fly's hands earlier. Betsy has stuff. What if I throw a bowl of salt at her? Oh wait.
That doesn't need to be any saltier.
Nope.
I can't use the Fernet there. I can't.
Nope. Sausage?
I will not use this sausage there.
Okay, that was informative. Biology book.
The only thing this is useful for is reading.
That's why giant flies.
I can't use these pills.
Nope. Okay, because we...
Something fishy is going on in the river. It's not a good idea considering the quantity of killer piranhas I released in this river.
Okay, I think it's the fish domingo in there.
That doesn't need
to... I will throw things into this river until it works.
I can't use the... I can't use the purple...
Okay. Is anything else I can interact with over here?
The only thing this is.
Do I have to read it again? Nope. No. Nope. Something about this. Okay. Tigers.
No thanks. No thanks.
No.
Well, my folks, we're gonna call it here. Beef fetch!
Money doesn't solve.
Yeah, we could do. It can solve a lot of things. Money solves a lot of things. Okay, town square. Actually, I don't think I talked to this demon here properly.
Hi.
Hey, it's not.
It is.
What makes you think that the paper boat you're holding in your.
What makes you think it isn't?
Can you show me how you made it?
Of course! I took a piece of paper. Then I moved this here. I folded in this corner, this folded in half. Give me a second.
This goes here.
This goes here.
Okay, yeah.
And
impressive.
Then we fold the wheels a bit to make them look more round, and ta-da!
I think there is a problem in that last step.
I know. The wheels don't look as good as I would like.
May I have it?
Yes, sure. Take it.
Okay. He actually made an impressive bike and then turned it to a boat.
You do understand that bikes don't have big sails on top of them, right?
Of course I understand that.
Then why has that thing got a big sail on top of it?
This is not a sail. Here's where the bike rider goes, just between the beak and three back legs.
Never mind.
Yep.
Just.
Yeah, okay, but we got a paper boat out of it.
Bye.
Goodbye.
I'm not.
Broom, broom.
Yeah, so essentially, yeah, we had a boat and then he turned it into a plane. But yeah, that's all for next time, though. When we come back, we shall find various items. I mean, we gotta make a sandwich now, and find stuff to make coffee. Well, plus we got purple tail. It was green, but now it's purple. That's legit, I think. Oh well, till next time, folks. Till next time, I'll catch you all later. See ya.